Well, I'd applied to do primary ed at Roehampton University before I went to Uganda, but I think it did definitely kind of tell me that I really wanted to do teaching, or definitely really wanted to work with children when I was out there, because they were all just so friendly and lovely, and definitely made me want to do more aid work and want to go back out there and work more with them, and it definitely, it has definitely made me a bit more determined to achieve what I want to, like, to become a primary school teacher. We tended to get to school at about 8:30, 9:30, but the children would get there at 7:30, so they'd already been at school for an hour, 2 hours, and I mean, the weather was really hot because I was right on the equator, so it was really, really hot, really intense. And lunch was always with matoki, which is like banana, kind of mashed up and then wrapped in banana leaves and then put in like in an oven, kind of like a furnace kind of thing. And we had it every single day, so got a bit bored of that. So that blended in with my typical day, matoki. I learnt a lot about the hierarchy of families over there and how much work the children have to do. They're at school all day long, like 7:30 until 5:00, and they get home and they've got to go and get the water and they've got to do everything. So their families really do depend on the children. And I think that's a really valuable thing to learn. The children in Uganda are a lot more attentive than English children. They love to listen and they're really interactive. But children over here, obviously, they are still quite interactive. And they're very lively and bubbly, but they're not as attentive. They don't see you as a different, interesting person. They just see you as an older person, so they kind of have to pay attention to you. Whereas over there, they want to, because you're so different. So they find you really interesting and intriguing. So they always ask questions. I think in that respect, I really enjoyed that because it was nice, like, teaching them that. Whereas over here, you do teach children, like, new things, but they kind of already have got that prior knowledge. They've already got in their head what they want to know. But in Africa, obviously, our way of life and their way of life is completely different, so they just find it interesting. So there was one girl who... she was a twin, and her sister was absolutely fine with us, but she just did not feel comfortable being in our presence at all. So when we first came into the classroom, my friend Alice was at the front, and I went to sit at the back with the children, and she just looked at me with this really empty gaze, and I just knew that she was going to burst out crying. And she just looked at me and just started screaming. And luckily, the teacher was her mum, so she managed to, like, pick her up and, like, comfort her. But she was just screaming and, like, crying and running away from me, and she just did not like it at all. But once I'd been there for a couple of days and, like, a week later, she was so much more comfortable with us. Like, she'd play games with us, like, and we'd, like, chase them and, like, play, like, it and stuff like that. And she was so much more comfortable, and she would always come up to me and, like, try and sit on my lap. And so it just took time for her to adjust to seeing a different kind of person. I don't know, like, what must have been going through her head. She must have been petrified because she was screaming so loudly. And if her mum hadn't been there, I really don't know what I would have done. But she was so sweet, and, like, her sister, she was fine with us straight away. I mean, I can't remember, like, when you're younger, you don't really remember seeing, like, different people and, like, what goes through your head. But for them, obviously, because they live in Africa and it's predominantly, like, black people, they kind of must have found it just really weird. But I mean, a couple of months ago, I got an email from the lady who's the headmistress at the primary school that I was volunteering at, And one of the little girls that was in the class that I was teaching had got run over by a motorbike and died. And that really upset me. It's really horrible, because when you're here, you feel just like you're living in your own life. You kind of forget everyone else is moving on. So it was horrible to think that that is all happening over there, and they've got all that to deal with. Their way of life kind of inspired me, because they just live every day as it comes, and they're all very, very happy people, even though they're living in, a lot of them were just like living in mud huts, and there's a lot of poverty, but I've never seen a happier bunch of people. They're always happy, always laughing, and I think that's definitely a really good place to be in. It's a good way to be, whereas over here, if you're in debt, you just get really depressed. But I mean, obviously it's a lot different, but I don't know, I just think a lot of people should take on board how they live over there, because it is so much happier. The whole kind of feel of their community is really nice, and they're all just one big family, and I think that's definitely a good way to be.